in a triangle PQR, if 3 sin P plus 4 cos Q equal to 6 and 4 sin Q plus 3 cos P equal to 1, then the angle R is equal to. So we need to find the angle R in the given triangle PQR. So let's start doing this question on the whiteboard. Let us first write the given condition. The given condition is 3 sin P plus 4 cos Q equal to 6, and the second condition is 4 sin Q plus 3 cos P equal to 1. Now if we wish to simplify this equation, the basic thing is that we can square both of them and both of them, that is squaring the equation number 1 and equation number 2 and adding them. Now if we square the first equation, it will become 9 sin square P plus 16 cos square Q plus 24 sin P cos Q equal to 36. On squaring the second equation, it turns out to be 16 sin square Q plus 9 cos square P plus 24 sin Q cos P equal to 1. Now if we add both these equations, we can see here that 9 sin square P is there, 9 cos square P is there, we take out 9 as a common, so we are getting 9 times sin square P plus cos square P plus. Now if we take 16 common out of them, we are getting 16 sin square Q plus cos square Q, and then from the left out terms we take out 24 common, that is from this one and this one we have taken out 24 as a common, so we are left with sin P cos Q plus sin Q cos P, and that is equals to 36 plus 1, that gives 37. Now we know that sin square P plus cos square P is nothing but 1, this will also be 1, so we are getting 9 plus 16 plus 24 times. Now if we observe carefully, it is sin P cos Q plus sin Q cos P, that is sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. So it is nothing but the formula for sin of A plus B. Here it will be sin of P plus Q, and that is equals to 37. Now 16 plus 9, that will be 25. It will go to the right hand side, that will subtract it from 37, that will give 37 minus 25, that will be 12. So 24 sin of P plus Q equals to 12, and that gives sin of P plus Q equals to 12 over 24, that is 1 by 2. So now the possibilities are that P plus Q equals to 30 degree, because we know sin of 30 degree is half. Also we know that sin of 180 minus theta is equals to sin theta. Therefore, we can conclude that P plus Q can also be equal to 150 degree. In both the cases, we will be having sin of P plus Q equal to half. So, if we take the first case, that is P plus Q equal to 30 degree, in that case, R will be equal to 150 degree, because we know that in the triangle PQR, angle P plus angle Q plus angle R equals to 180 degree. Now P plus Q is equal to 30 degree, so 30 degree plus angle R turns out to be 180 degree. That will give angle R equal to 150 degree. That's why we have written over here. Now if we wish to check whether this is the correct thing or not, we need to take the help of given conditions. So we proceed this like P plus Q is equals to 30 degree. So from this we can say that P is definitely less than 30 degree but greater than 0 degree, and Q is also less than 0 degree, sorry, greater than 0 degree but less than 30 degree. Let us continue on the next whiteboard as the space is over here. So now I am writing the condition again that P is less than 30 degree, greater than 0 degree. Q is less than 30 degree but greater than 0 degree. So if we take the first one, let us name this as the first equation or first inequality rather. Then if we take sine on the three sides of the given equality, we have sine of 0, sine of P and sine of 30 degree. Now as we know that if x1 is less than f of x2, then f of x1 will be less than f of x2 if the function is increasing. And we know that sin x is an increasing function from x belonging to 0 to pi by 2. That's why the sign of inequality remains the same. From here we can say that sin p is greater than 0 but less than sin 30, that is half. Now for q, what we take, it is lying between 0 to 30 degree. Therefore if we take cos on all the three sides, what will happen? Cos q will be here, cos 30 degree will be here and cos 0 will be here. But we know one thing, that cos x is a decreasing function from 0 to pi by 2. And we know that if x1 is less than x2 and a function is a decreasing function, then f of x1 will be greater than f of x2. That is the sign of inequality reverses. Therefore the sign of inequality will be like this, or we can say that cos q is now lying between cos of 30 degree and cos of 0. That will give cos q is lying between root 3 by 2 and 1. So we can say that the upper limit for cos q is 1. Now the first condition is given to us that 3 sin p plus 4 cos q equal to 6. Now we take the help of the inequality which we have just discussed, that says that sin p is less than half. So from this we can say that 3 sin p will be less than 3 by 2. Similarly here we can see that cos q is less than 1. Therefore 4 cos q will be less than 4. If we add both of them, we will be getting 3 sin p plus 4 cos q is less than 4 plus 3 by 2. But in the condition it is given 6, here it will come out to be 5.5. Therefore the argument is not matching. So the condition which we have taken, that is P plus Q equal to 30, is incorrect. Therefore P plus Q equal to 150 degree is the correct condition. And from this we can say that angle R is equals to 180 minus P plus Q, that is 180 minus 150 degree, and that is equals to 30 degree or pi by 6. So the correct answer for the given question will be pi by 6. Let's check from the question paper which is the correct option. It is the option B which is the correct one.